The sun was shining. It was a hot day, and the sun's rays were lighting up patches of ground in the dark jungle. Under a tree, a huge figure lay sleeping, shielded from the sun in the shade. It was Lizarov Lion. Lizarov was king of the jungle. He kept law and order in the jungle and punished anybody who crossed his path. A small spider was crawling on the leaves that had fallen from the trees. It crept towards Lizarov and climbed up the huge body, thinking it was a rock. As the spider moved across Lizarov's body, it passed the huge head, which contained razor-sharp teeth, and made its way towards the tail. Before the spider could move any further, Lizarov swung his long tail and connected with the spider and sent it flying through the air. Lizarov sprung to his feet and shook his head vigorously to awaken from his nap.
"Who disturbed me from my sleep?" roared Lizarov as he looked around in anger. "I am king of the jungle! If I find out who disturbed my sleep, I will punish them severely. Come out from your hiding place, and I will let you off with a warning," he added.
There was no reaction. Lizarov looked in every direction, but could see no one.
"I've a good idea who might have done this, and when I see any of those four misfits, I will make them pay," thought Lizarov.
The teacher was busy writing on the blackboard. It was mathematics, a subject not high on the likes list in Cheekio's book. Cheekio Chimp was always up to mischief. Pranks, jokes and misbehaviour were a way of life for Cheekio. Elzina Elephant sat beside Cheekio. She was a keen scholar. Peering over her spectacles, she never took her eyes off the teacher. Behind sat Himaku Hippo and Zebgarn Zebra. Cheekio was very bored and let out a yawn.
"Oh, this is so boring.
What good is maths when all I do all day is climb trees?" asked Cheekio as he stared out of the open classroom window.
"Shush,"
said Elzina as she kept her eyes on the blackboard.
"I need to liven things up here, otherwise I'm going to fall asleep," thought Cheekio.
Cheekio reached into his school bag, hanging over his chair, and pulled out a small box. He carefully opened the small box and reached inside. Cheekio let out a giggle and quickly looked up to see if the teacher was looking. She wasn't. He slowly picked something up from inside and gently placed it in the palm of his hand.
"Let's have a bit of fun," smirked Cheekio to his hand.
Cheekio stroked his furry friend and placed the small mouse behind his book, which he had propped up and opened, shielding it from the teacher.
"Who can answer the following problem?"
asked the teacher as she pointed at the equation on the blackboard. Cheekio was playing with the mouse, not paying attention. Elzina had her hand raised high into the air.
"Stand up, Cheekio,"
said the teacher with anger in her tone. Cheekio looked up at the teacher and stood up.
"Do you know the answer?" asked the teacher.
Cheekio thought for a moment.
4.5,
replied Cheekio half-heartedly.
"Tell him, Elzina,"
said the teacher, nodding her head.
"It's 24!
Screamed Elzina as she jumped back from her desk. Cheekio looked for his furry friend from behind his book, but he was gone.
Elzina ran from her desk and out of the classroom, shouting at Cheekio as she ran. "Ah, there's a rat on my desk! Was that you, Cheekio?"
she screamed.
"Whatever is up with Elzina?" asked a confused teacher.
"Your maths lessons are getting harder," smirked Cheekio.
"That was a terrible prank you played on me," said Elzina in disgust.
"It wasn't me. The mouse must have run onto your desk," smiled Cheekio.
The four friends were on their way home from school. It was a mild day, and the sun was trying to shine from behind the clouds.
"You should behave yourself, especially in class," moaned Himaku.
"You are lucky the teacher did not see the mouse. She would have known only you could have brought that vile animal into the classroom,"
said Zebgarn, as he looked at Cheekio in disbelief.
The four entered deeper into the jungle. Their homes were not that far away. Anyway, how come a big, huge, enormous animal like Elzinar is afraid of a small, tiny, teensy mouse? Asked Cheekio as he scratched his head. Three heads turned and looked at Elzinar, walking at the rear. They are so small. I'm afraid they might run inside my trunk, replied Elzinar in embarrassment.
I am not small. Are you afraid of me?
Four heads turned and looked straight ahead. There, in front of the four friends, stood a figure that would frighten even the bravest of them all. Claws were visible. They were long and came to a sharp point at the tip. As the figure spoke, you could see his teeth. They too were long and sharp, in a big mouth, on a big face, with a golden mane covering the head. A ferocious sight. As the sun came out from behind the clouds, it lit up the five animals like a spotlight. The figure was Lizarov. Lizarov circled the four friends. The four huddled together, keeping their eyes focused on Lizarov, looking for an opportunity to escape.
I've been looking for you, roared Lizarov. I thought I might catch one of you, but instead I have all four, boasted Lizarov with a grin.
What have we done? Asked Himarku nervously.
Silence! Roared Lizarov. Have you no respect? I am king of the jungle. Call me your highness or sir, he added, holding his head high.
What have we done, your highness? Asked Himarku again.
One of you disturbed me when I was taking a nap, replied Lizarov.
When, sir? Asked Sebgarn.
Yesterday morning, replied Lizarov.
We were all at school, your highness. It must have been somebody else, said Elzinar, lowering her head.
I don't believe you. Anyway, I have to punish you as a message to others, roared Lizarov.
Please, your highness, don't punish us. We are defenseless and weaker than you. Please let us go, begged Elzinar. Lizarov stopped circling the four and looked at Elzinar. He went into deep thought. He remembered when he was a small cub. The four friends looked at one another and decided this was the time to make their escape. Lizarov was looking at the ground, unaware of their bid to escape. Just as Himarku turned to run, he slipped on a pebble and fell to the floor. Zebgarn, Cheekio and Elzinar ran into Himarku and fell flat on their backs. Lizarov quickly gathered his senses and stood tall in front of the pile of friends.
Stop! I have something I must tell you, said Lizarov.
Lizarov sat in front of the four friends. The four sat in a line and listened to Lizarov.
I have something I must tell you, said Lizarov,
his tone unusually soft. The friends listened, paying attention to the person at the front. More respect went to this ferocious beast than the school teacher in the classroom.
I too was a victim of bigger animals when I was younger. I was a small cub, and older lions would pick on me. My mother used to say that one day I would be king of the jungle and nobody would ever stand in my way. I grew taller and stronger as the years went by. I was taught that to maintain honor and law and order in the jungle, I had to discipline anyone who broke any of the laws. Fear was a weapon, said Lizarov as he turned to each friend.
The friends listened.
Because of my role in the jungle, I found it hard to make friends. Animals used to run away when they saw or heard me approaching. In fact, I have no friends, said Lizarov, sounding unhappy.
Lizarov looked at the four friends, sitting and listening intently. He turned away from them and looked into the deep jungle.
I am king of this jungle, and you are all my servants. What I would like are friends, not servants. I could go sunbathing, running, and play all the fun games everybody plays. Instead, I have to maintain this image to keep order. If only I had friends, even one friend. So, I would like to spare all of you from punishment, if you would be my friends, asked Lizarov, as he continued looking into the deep jungle. There was no reply. I would not chase you or make your lives difficult if you just became my friends. So what do you say? Asked Lizarov. There was still no reply. Speak up! There is no need to be afraid, whispered Lizarov. A small spider climbed on Lizarov's back as he sat. With a swish of his tail, he threw the spider off. Lizarov jumped to his feet and realized what had disturbed him from his nap earlier. He turned around to announce the news to his new friends.
You cheeky devils! Wait till I catch you! Roared Lizarov.
The four friends had gone.